The Serpent Mound is one of the most impressive effigy mounds that we see built by the Mississippians. Now, an effigy mound is a mound in the form of some creature. So unlike Cahokia, where we see mounds usually with structures on top, or other places where we see burial mounds, which are simply a mound, here it's being shaped into something, in this case, a serpent. Now, this is going to be found in Ohio, and it's actually about a quarter mile in length. It's actually quite an expansive form. We find no evidence of burial within the serpent mound itself. And snakes would have been associated with earth and fertility. It may have also been used as an observatory or some form of calendar. Again, in ancient societies, as well as many modern societies, calendars take on an important role. A farmer needs to know when it's safe to plant their crops. If it's warm in the beginning of March or the end of February, you don't want to be tricked into using the little bit that you've held back for seed to plant your crops and then have it die when it gets cold again. So here we see there is some alignment from one position of the summer solstice, the spring and autumn equinox, and the winter solstice. And really, with these three dates, you could tell where you are in the year and properly plant your crops. So it is one possibility. Another is that the Serpent Mound may be related to the 1066 sighting of Halley's Comet. Now, serpents and comets look very, very similar. In fact, in this case, the serpent has this large round head and then comes back into this sinuous curvilinear tail. Very similar to what you would see from Halley's Comet, which is, of course, visible by the naked eye. And you would have the appearance of the head and the tail stretching across the sky above you. These sort of cosmic phenomena are seen by all societies as something of particular importance. In fact, if you think back, almost every time there's a major eclipse or a comet visible or any number of other phenomena, from hail-bop to any other, you will have people coming out saying, you know, this is the end of the world, this is the second coming, whatever it is. And that's not just Western society. You see that amongst all societies when there's something so massive and yet so unexplained happening. They're trying to find a way to understand this phenomena, and they're going to go back to their mythology to do it. Something else to keep in mind is this would have been built by a massive labor force. They don't have earthworking tools, so they're building it basically with baskets, moving baskets of dirt one at a time. Imagine filling basically a laundry basket with dirt and then trying to create this form. You would have to move it from somewhere, you would have to put it in place, you would have to shape it and compact it so that it would last as long as it has. These are not easily built, and there must be a reason that they're putting these resources in, which means it's probably religious. It probably has some tie to their mythology. We're just not sure what that tie is. And with no burial in it, it's unlikely that it's tied to a specific ruler. But these things are proven wrong all the time.